well, so we are going to see Storm coming out, and the expansion goes down. He is so far ahead right now.
That Psionic Storm could
be very useful. He's going to crush the legend. Jag tror det var faktiskt.
Båda spelarna tog ut varandras baser, så nu har de byggt om sin bas i den motståndarens startposition. Nu börjar ju i princip matchen om. Kommentatorerna sa att det blir som en övertid, och det är lite så. Sen är dock ut som koreanen, Gojila, en fördel. Han har jäkligt många stalkers, eller dragons. Och jävligt bra reapers också.
Publiken, det var inte riktigt så många människor som kollade på Counter-Strike, men nu är det fullt så mycket det går.
Ja,
vi pratade om det innan, Starcraft 1, eller ja, Broad War då, på ett uppsving i
Vietnam. He's going to miss the movement to the base, and it depends, if is he going to get that observer out in time to actually spot these? Does he go to the base to find out what's going on, or is he going to use it in a defensive manner?
Like you said, not re-teching fast enough, and he sends a shuttle out to the left that is not an observer, moving too slow, so these DTs are going to be able to run around just unhithered right now for a little while. He's waiting for that observer to come out, just waiting for a blue dot to appear, and there it is. So he's going to have to do some work on that. He's going to move them into the left. They took out his observer, so he's going in blind right now. He's going for the economy. He's going to try to hit this hard.
He's going to do as much damage as possible. The observer is out. They are going to go down, but so many frogs went down. Five, six, so much damage, especially because he's on one base. He doesn't have that many probes. What a great move there by Gojila.
It really was, and to not send his whole force in at once, he knew that Legend was already behind just a little bit. That was going to hurt him that much more, so he's chipping away at this point at the game of Legend and the economy, and right now we can see that it's hurting. Legend was a little bit slower to attack, a little bit slower to just get that observer out, and we see DT's already coming off a fresh build of Gojila's side.
And the food count right now, 86 versus 63. Gojila pulling ahead now, showing his quality and experience as being a professional player in South Korea versus Legendary. We are moving in for a push right now. Oh, and I say, the Johnson goes down. The ring's going to go down as well. Oh, huge
the backliner stays alive though, and the shield of the Dragoons is going to try to keep that alive. However, another Reaver in the base on the top side of the ramp will stop them from pushing it any further. A pretty good trade by both of the players, and they will kind of hold off in the stalemate once again. But here we go, some reinforcements, and like I said, not much air in this game. We're going to see a lot of ground.
I mean, look at that. Oh, great hit there by that Reaver doing a lot. And there's so much damage.
Scared of the rest.
The thing is, he has just the economical advantage right now. Oh, he's got to be careful with that Reaver. Oh, he picks it up just in time. Great mic for that. Michael Dillon doing so much damage. He won't
that
be able to
That Reaver is now gone for Legendary, so we're going to have to see here. They have the upper hand on the outside in range. Both the Dragoons also have range on both players' side, but those Reavers are just playing the game right now of harassment on that ramp.
Yeah, he's slowly picking up units one by one of Legendary. He has the expansion now fully running, enough probes down there. I mean, he's just got this super contained. Legendary just can't do anything. He can't move out. It looks like he's moving a shuttle to the left-hand side to see if he can do any form of harassment.
Scare getting stuck there. This is one of those games where if you have a lot of money, it means you're losing. You need to be spending your money at all times. Right now, Gojila is doing just that. Keeps reinforcing. Here's another pile of Dragoons to back up the ones outside the base. There they are, four to five more every time. And still, he's building during the attack and keeping his micro going.
And look at that. These Dragoons going in, doing some form of harassment, also scouting, because that's what they're going to be able to do. The four Dragoons there, spot it straight away. And he's going to go down, see that expansion, and know that he's so far behind.
Yes, once he sees that expansion, and actually how many probes are already on it. It is that far behind, and then he can just keep pumping out those units on Legends or on Gojila's side. Gojila taking the upper hand with that, getting that Reaver out just a few minutes before that Legend did. He was able to do that damage on the base trade that stopped Legend from a fast rebuild because he had to have so many probes back.
Yeah, and it looks like because of where the expansion is on the top left, there's no gas there, so you can't actually go super gas heavy, so that he had to delay leg speed for the Zealots. He's going to be pumping out a lot more Zealots now because Reavers are so gas heavy. He doesn't actually have that much gas.
And now a third expansion going out as Gojila feeling very confident about the play. He sets that up, and here we go, a little bit of attack outside of Legend's base. It's going to be a heavy one. Fully Dragoons on the front. I do not see the Reaver in this gameplay right now, but the Observer is definitely giving Legend some help here and seeing all those Dragoons, and they're going to line up on both sides and try to do some damage.
And it looks like Legendary needs to try to hold on to it. GG! Well played by both players. Legendary right now, he just needed to do something. fantastic. He was so far behind the economy, he had to go out and
find a lot. Ja, en sista kommentar, vad säger vi?
Jäkligt spännande match. Lång match och kändes som att Legion spelade riktigt bra ändå. Sen i långa loppet så var koreanen för stark med tre baser och mycket bättre ekonomi. Men ja, bra start på Starcraft-turneringen i World Cyber Games 2010.
Den sista Starcraft-turneringen borde vara kanske?
Förmodligen, i alla fall i VCG-sammanhang. 2010 and the 10th anniversary of World Cyber Games here in beautiful Los Angeles.